if you want to do some good to your family members, you know, you share with them the belief, you know, of the one God based on his names and attributes. And then whenever they, you know, they feel hopeless because they go through a certain situation, right? Instead of them questioning, why did this happen to me? And God, life is so unfair. If they know that Allah is al-adl, the more, you know, the just, right? Or al-hakim, you know, the wise, or the one that deals with wisdom, or al-hakim, the one that is the one that's gonna judge, right? The judge, but he judges based on wisdom. You have a relationship to offer them that whenever they're in times of difficulty, they can call out based on his names and attributes. You know, even if they're not Muslim, they'll benefit from you having a solid relationship with the one who created you. And that's irresistible for some people. They're like, man, how can I get some of that? I want to feel peaceful the way you feel peaceful. You know, I notice you're not drinking anymore. I notice you're not going out doing this, doing that. Why? It's like, well, I actually got to know, you know, my purpose of life, right? By studying the one who created me better. You go on to realize more, get to learn more about who Allah is. And when you learn the names and attributes of Allah, right, that Allah is the most merciful, that he's the all-seer, the all-hearer, the creator, the sustainer, you know, the maintainer. All of these names and attributes are things that people aspire to. They wish they knew the heightened level of, you know, of the source of where all this comes from. So always, you know, whether we're born in Islam or whether we are, you know, converts or reverts or, you know, accepting Islam, there's always one priority that Islam calls to, and that is to Allah alone, because that's the very basis of Islam. So don't be like sidestepped on secondary issues and thirdary issues. Oh, why don't you eat pork? And, you know, we don't eat pork because of this. And all of these things have their own place. But even if you debate the issue of pork and they're like, oh, okay, got it. You know, I totally will stop eating pork. That doesn't benefit them, you know, as much as I didn't know about Allah. And now that I do, I want to have that relationship as well. If we don't know who Allah is, if we don't know who the creator of the heavens and the earth is, then how can we, you know, act in accordance to what he wants from us? So the most important thing should be to understand who Allah is. And that leads us to understanding as Muslims, I mean, the person who's asking this question, right? We would encourage them to learn about the names and attributes of Allah. Because the more you know Allah, the more you are able to distinguish, you know, what is not, right, God, what is not Allah. And there's a lot of confusion in the world today in regards to who is God. You know, from amongst Muslims sometimes, they may, you know, even go on and commit some mistakes regarding the worship of Allah, you know, if they have a lack of understanding, you know, of his lordship being unique, or his worship being unique, and his names and attributes being unique. That's the one distinguishing factor also of Islam in regards to all the other religions and philosophies in the world. When a person looks at Islam in the theology, the concept of God, right, just from a pure standpoint as to, you know, answering the question, who is God, right? So many people ask themselves this at some stage of their life. You know, even those that say, oh, I don't believe in God, like, really, there's an underlying issue there with them having gone through something a good majority of the time, thinking, well, if this happened to me, there can't be a God, right? So that in and of itself shows that they feel that they're, you know, if there were to be something more, right, it would have to be fill in the blank, right? People are trying to fill in that blank so many different ways. Some externalize it, ask about it. Some go searching for it. Others just question life in general. You know what I mean? Why am I here? What am I doing? And, you know, what's this all about? So the oneness of God is so clear in Islam that when you look at the evidence coming from the Book of Allah and the statements of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, you realize that purity of how the prophets believed in God throughout the ages. Doesn't matter what prophet we're talking about, including Jesus and Moses and Abraham. All of them, you know, had a purity regarding how they believed in God. There was nothing, you know, higher than the creator of the heavens and the earth. And there was nothing that could be partnered with him or associated to him. So whenever people want to pray to an intermediary, right, to an idol, to a statue, in order to get to God, right, the clarity as to how all the prophets dealt with their relationship with God, Abraham, for example, right, it was direct. That's why so many people, such as the person who asked, you know, the question, has accepted Islam because of that relationship. So let that be always a priority. And if Allah Azza wa Jal is, you know, if he's merciful, you got to also implement that sense of mercy when dealing with people, even if they don't understand you. Why? Because you believe that Allah is merciful. And if you're merciful to them, he'll be merciful to you. So your etiquette as to how you call people to Islam should be based on these names and attributes and you exercising them to the best of your ability. That's what we have to go back to learn, implement, and then inshallah call people to that. And then obviously make dua that Allah guide them.